Have you ever faced a situation when your flow failed at a point and doesn't execute preceding actions and you don't know how to handle it? Well, the answer is error handling. That's what I'm going to show you in this video using try catch and finally blocks like we do in programming language. Hi, my name is Akash. I'm a Microsoft certified professional and I have been working with Microsoft services since last 10 years. Today, I'll be showing you how to do error handling in Power Automate. So without any delay, let's do the action. I'm on the homepage of Power Automate. Let's create a flow quickly where we can try to replicate a scenario where a flow fails and doesn't execute after the failed action. We'll go to create in the left navigation and we will choose to create instant cloud flow. For the demo purpose, I'll choose to execute the flow manually. So I'll choose manually trigger a flow and name it demo flow. Let's click create. Now we have a blank flow which is doing nothing. So let's do something in the flow. Add an action from here. Type send an email and choose send an email action. To keep it simple, I'm just going to send an email to a user with subject test subject and body as test body. Now let's say I do not have an email ID of the user, but I have the UPN. But I know I can get the user profile from UPN by using an action called get user profile. So I will add an action here called get user profile. And we'll type the UPN in the user field. For the demo purpose, I will type a UPN which doesn't exist in my tenant. So I will type some random demo test user at the rate my tenant. And I know this user profile doesn't exist, but I want this flow to throw error. And in the to field in send an email action, we will select email from get user profile action. And this completes our flow. We will save it and test it from top right. We'll select manually and test it. You can see that the flow failed at step get user profile and did not execute after this. But what if we want to execute some steps even if the above steps fail? Or what if I want to log this error? To solve this problem, we will use an action called scope. So we will edit the flow. We will add an action called scope. Now rename this action and name it try. Any action in your flow which is uncertain will go inside try. That's exactly how we do in normal programming languages. So I will drag this action on top of get user profile and one by one I will drag both the actions inside try. Now we will add another action called scope and this time we will rename it to catch. In catch we will put anything which we want to run when try fails. The most important part here is to configure catch to run when try action fails. And we will select has failed and deselect is successful. After doing this, we'll click done. And now this will make sure that whenever try action will fail, then catch will execute. Similarly, we will add finally scope. Just like catch, we have to configure finally block as well. And we have to make sure that this block runs when the catch is successful or when the catch is failed or when it is skipped. Basically, this should run in all the scenarios. And finally, we will add all the actions that should run irrespective of the above actions if executed successfully or not. Let's say I want to log in a SharePoint list in the end of the flow. So I will select action, create an item from SharePoint connector, and I will select my demo site. I will select my logs list. In the title here, I want to capture the status of the flow. So to capture the status of the flow, I'll initialize a variable on the top. I will name the variable status, and it will be of type string. I will keep it empty. In the try block, I will set this variable. I will set this variable to success. Or if try fails and the flow goes to catch action, then I want to set this variable to error. And finally, I am capturing the status in the title column of the list logs. Now let's save this flow and test it. You can see this time your flow ran successfully, although the try part did not run successfully, but we knew that it's going to fail because the user we are trying to find in get user profile action does not exist. So we can see the catch block executed and it set the variable status to error. And finally, we logged the status in the list called logs. To check the status, we'll go to log list in SharePoint, and we can see error is logged in the title column of the list. This time, I will try to put a user which exists in my tenant and run the flow. You can see this time the flow ran again successfully. The difference is that try block did not throw any error and executed all its function successfully. And hence, catch block was skipped by flow and it executed the final block in the end. So let's go to the log list and check what message is logged. We can see the last message logged is success. That means the try block has successfully set the variable value, which is success here. So this way you can handle any error in your flow by using scope actions. I hope this video helped you understand error handling in Power Automate and you learn something new. You can also let me know in comments if you have any doubts or if you have any questions, or probably if you want me to cover any topic in Power Automate. If you found this video useful, give it a like. And if you want to keep up with all the latest quick tip videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel so you get notified for all the new videos that I post.